Salut mes amis! So I had to reinstall my girlfriend's computer and I thought it would be a good idea to show you guys how to install my config and settings. If you are new to the game or if you want to reinstall your computer, this video will help you. So I've just installed CSGO and the first thing we want to do is right click on the game, choose properties and set launch options. Type -novid to skip the intro video, -console to get the console, and -tickrate 128 so you can create a lobby with friends and have 128 tickrate. The last thing we're gonna add is +exec, which will execute a config file automatically that we will create later. For now, I'll call it something simple and easy to remember. Also, make sure to add .cfg in the end. Now, starting the game for the first time, we'll create folders and files, which we will go to after the game has loaded completely. When the game is opened and you see the console, you can now minimize the game and create a config. Go to where you have installed Steam, Userdata, and if you have only one Steam account on your computer, you should only see one folder here. If you have more than one folder, you can check the video description for more info. Go to 730, local, and CFG. Now we need to open the config file that has been created by the game. Open the file with Notepad or any other text editing program. I prefer Notepad++. It's free and easy to install. Find this command and change the value to 0. This will make sure that the game doesn't override any view model settings. Now close the file and copy it. After you copy it, paste it in the same folder and rename it. Use the same exact name that you have chosen in your launch options. Let's continue. Open your new config file and remove everything inside. Alright, so now we need to save some settings in here. I'm gonna link my own config in the video description that you can use. I've put a lot of time into this config and I recommend using it because it has all the important tweaks and settings that are good for competitive players. I've also added explanations to every command in case you're interested in what they do. Paste the settings in your new config file and soon I will show you how to change your crosshair. Save the file and resume your game. Now in the console, type exec and the name of your config. Press enter and now the settings are loaded. Before we continue, you need to bind a key so you're able to bring up your console anytime. Go to keyboard settings and you'll find it at the bottom. Now it's time to change your video settings. I myself recommend using the highest possible resolution for the monitor and these settings in advanced video options. If your computer is not capable of running these settings, lower your resolution and lower these four settings before changing anything else. When you have saved your video settings, it's time to choose a crosshair. Go to the link in the video description and subscribe to Crash's Crosshair Generator Map. When you're subscribed to the map, you can go to Offline with Bots, Workshop, and from there you should be able to see it. If not, refresh. It doesn't matter what settings you choose here, you can just start the map. When you're in-game, you can make a crosshair or choose one that already exists. When you feel done, go here and click Share Crosshair. Copy all the commands that pop up in the console and replace them with my own crosshair settings. By the way, if you want to change the color of your HUD, find CL HUD color in the config and choose a number between 0 and 10. I'm gonna use purple to match the crosshair, so I have to choose number 4. Last thing you want to change is the view model settings. I recommend the view model settings that I use, but if you want to change them, you can find them in the config. Go back in-game and execute your config file again to see the changes. Now it's time to adjust your sensitivity. Go outside the map and start shooting the enemies that spawn as fast as you can in the head. If you're struggling to hit an enemy and you pass them with your crosshair too much, lower your sensitivity. I use in-game sensitivity of 2 and 400 dpi, which is lower than usual, but goes great with my large mouse pad. If you want my recommendation, use a sensitivity that allows you to make a 180 by moving your mouse from one side of your mouse pad to the other. Now you should be ready to go, but there is one more thing I like to do, and that's to install Vibrance GUI, which will increase the saturation of the colors in game. This helps with vision and makes the game look less boring. Alright guys, thank you for watching. This is Maxime, stay awesome, and go bananas.